In this video, we'll find the largest LeBron diamond within any budget. My budget for today is $2,500, but it doesn't matter if you have a different budget. The process is the same. The average consumer spends 3-6 months studying and doing research before buying. My goal is to show you how simple it is to find your diamond today. But before that, if you need help finding the right one, click on the Let's Find a Diamond link below, take the short quiz, and I will do the research for you for free. And now, let's start. So how do we find the largest diamond? As you may already know, there are four main factors to evaluate the quality of each diamond. We call them the four C's: carat, color, clarity, and cut. Combine them all together with some extra profit for the retailer and you get the diamond's price. In our case, the price is our maximum budget, $2,500. If we decide to prioritize carat weight, we must compromise over other factors. Since there is no point in getting a diamond with no sparkle, we won't compromise over cut. On the other end, can you tell which diamond has a higher color? And can you tell which diamond has a higher clarity? A naked eye, especially untrained, can barely tell the difference when picked right. So if we compromise over color and clarity, we can channel more of the budget into a larger diamond. So for example, we can compromise just a little, find a good VS2 with F coalesce, and see which carat weight we get. If we are happy with the result, great. And if we want a larger diamond, what should we do? We'll have to sacrifice more color and clarity. Remember, we need to play with the factors, but the end result must balance everything. And now, let's find a diamond. Click on the first link below to open the diamond gallery. Make sure to click on Lab Created Diamonds. My budget for today is $2,500, so I'll type it in as the maximum price. You can enter your own budget and follow along. Next, let's sort the diamonds by carat from high to low, because we want to see the largest options first. We don't compromise over cut, so click on advanced options and choose excellent polish and excellent symmetry to have a XXX diamond. To ensure we get the best round diamonds, I'll filter by depth 59 to 63 and table 54 to 60. For fluorescence, I'll choose none. Since lab diamonds are affordable, there is no reason to compromise too much over color and clarity. So first, focus on G, VS2 and higher. If you are not happy with the largest option you get, you can increase the budget or look for SI1 and lower color. You can see that right from the start, most of the diamonds are beautiful and have a good cut that shows the black arrows of the diamond, but we can't see the real color. So to see the actual color of the diamond, click on the side view. You can see that some diamonds share the exact same grade, but actually look different. Some are brighter than others. It happens because each grade contains a wide range of colors, like sublevels. For example, there are G colors that show a yellowish, grayish, or bluish tint, while other G colors look brighter, almost colorless. This is why we need to make sure to pick the brightest option available inside that range. When finding a diamond with good color from the side view, hover the mouse to check the face-up view. This way, we can save time and see if it looks beautiful before opening the diamond's page. We can also click on the magnifying glass icon to open a pop-up with the diamond's video. Because I'm not happy with the color of my options, I'll narrow it down to F and IR. The carat weight went down a little, but it's not significant. I prefer to get a brighter diamond over a 0.05 carat. Most of the diamonds are now colorless, so the next step is to make sure that the diamond is eye clean, meaning we cannot see the flaws with a naked eye, and it has a beautiful cut that shows the black arrows with a lot of brilliance and sparkle. I'll browse the gallery and check the diamonds. If I see a good option, I'll open it in a new tab and continue the research until I reach the minimum carat weight I wish to get. In that case, my goal is 1.28 carat or larger. If a diamond has a big flaw over the table, I'll move on to the next one. The inventory is large enough and I know I can find better options. If the flaw is located over the facets and it blends well with the sparkles and the color of the diamond, it's an eye clean diamond, so I'll open it and check it later. So I've opened this diamond. It's currently under a sale and sold for $2,480. So not only it's one of the largest options, it also has almost the highest color, E-colorless, and eye clean VS1 clarity. You can see that strong contrast between the black arrows and the bright color. The IGI even graded it as a Hartzinger's diamond, meaning it has a superb cut with high light performance. Such a diamond shows much more brilliance, fire and sparkle than an average ideal cut, which naturally involves a higher cost. So for this price, it's a great deal. The next step is to contact customer service and ask them to put this diamond on hold until you make your final decision. Don't let someone else get it before you. Some will love this option and take it right away, but as I said before, some prefer to compromise even more over color and clarity to get a larger diamond. So let's do that. Go back to the gallery, change to J&SI1 minimum. Same as before, browse the gallery, open different diamonds, check the color from the side view and make sure it's an eye clean diamond from the top view. The first option is a 1.51 carat with eye color that looks pretty much colorless from the top view and has a good VS2 eye clean clarity. The second option is a 1.33 carat with D-colorless, the highest color in the chart. It has SI1 clarity with inclusions over the facet. I barely see them when zooming out, so I feel comfortable enough considering it as eye clean. So to sum it up, for the same budget, we have three options. A 1.29 carat with a better balance between all factors, a 1.51 carat with lower color, and a 1.33 carat with lower clarity. Choose the one you like the most based on your priority. All diamonds on this video are from the same vendor, which I found is the most competitive and has the best prices in the market. It has the best preview technology that allows you to inspect the diamonds like nowhere else. You can start the research by clicking the link below and look for the right diamond. Check the diamonds with the 360 HD videos and try to find the right one. If you think you found the right one, if you are not sure which one to get, or if you simply need an expert on your side, contact me and I'll be glad to give you my free advice. In any case, I'm on your side. If you want to let me do the heavy lifting, click the Find a Diamond link below, answer the questions, and I will do the research for you for free. If you want to learn more about diamonds, go to labdiamondsreview.com.